It's interesting to be able to revisit a character again and to see a different arc in the character. So kind of where Alejandro left off in the past, when you see Matt for the first time in this movie, something's shifted, something's changed. Something's maybe a little more deepened a bit, you know, at least on a dirty scale, you know what I mean? He's just a little darker.
It's kind of like a new assignment, you know, the way I look at this story. But through that assignment, you know, a lot of things are revealed and characters are emotionally, the characters are taken from here, from A to Z, really.
Isabel and Alejandro's relationship is really interesting because you basically watch it develop before your eyes. First, he has his doubts about her. He really couldn't care less about her. And she, same to her, she just wants to get home. Isabella's just trying to get by. She's just trying to get out of the situation, back to her like princess life, which Alejandro calls it. That situation is very hard for her. The whole movie, she's like, can I trust you? No, can I trust you? It's like throwing a little puppy into an ocean of sharks, you know? She's just trying to get out.
What I thought was fascinating was it doesn't feel like a sequel. It feels like another examination of yet another atrocity that's happening between the U.S. and Mexico, and how these, which I don't know a lot about, these mules, these children who are being corrupted into this very violent world and how sad it is. We're supposed to bring Isabella to a rival cartel, and it's supposed to just be a simple drop-off. And we've got all of this military power and we have all of this air support, and it just goes horribly wrong. And it's the big pivot of the whole movie in the middle of it, and really thrust the whole second half of the movie into a kind of a chaos. And I just loved it when I shot it, and I loved what Stefano was creating, and I can't wait to see it on the screen.
Being Mexican, it's a very personal thing, because these things do happen in Mexico, you know. It's not like, for us, it's not fiction. So I think it's important that this tells a story in both sides, like, you know, what really happens, you know, and like how the governments are involved and how the cartels are involved, and you know, everything from the ground. So that, I think it's important too, that people see what's happening out there.
I loved Taylor's use of Isabel and allowing the audience to fall in love with this girl who was rough, but comes from a privileged, wealthy Mexican side, the cartel side, but she's innocent, and to the extent that she only knows a little. And I love the humanity of this script, but seen through her eyes. And also, to an extent, Alejandro, because he has to make a tough decision whether he's gonna follow through with this mission or he's gonna do the right thing.
One of the real sort of the exciting things that came out of the first movie was just the camaraderie, the brotherhood between Matt and Alejandro. We just thought there was something there, even more than what we saw in the script. It kind of came together, came to life on the set, even though it was in the script. It's just the way in which these two guys performed, those two characters, Matt and Alejandro, it left us with this brotherhood that we really wanted to dive deeper into.
I know who you are. You're the attorney whose family they killed.
Not they.
My father.
Póntelos.
And now you hunt them.
Adios.
Proof the cartel helped the terrorists get to the border.
The president's adding drug cartels to the list of terrorist organizations.
You can understand how that will expand our ability to combat them.
You want to see this thing through? I'm gonna have to get dirty.
Dirty is exactly why you're here.
You're gonna help us start a war.
With who?
Everyone. No rules this time.
Your objective is to start a war between the Mexican cartels. Not with the Mexican government.
This girl was witness to the mission, correct?
Yes, sir.
We can't risk her falling into the wrong hands. Clean the scene.
They want me to cut ties. You gotta get rid of her.
I can't do that.
Don't put me in that situation.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
I'm gonna need a strike team to Blackhawks. Drones with attack capability.
Where's the coup?
Mexico.
You have no reason to trust me. But trusting me is how you're gonna survive.
Good luck.
Luck doesn't live on this side of the border.